Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Beefcake Games. I'm your host, Beefcake. Today we're going to be playing some more Metal Gear Solid 5, The Phantom Pain. We're going to do mission number 5. I believe it's called Over the Fence. So in this mission, we need to rescue a bionics engineer. Turns out he's the same guy that developed Snake's prosthetic arm. So he's going to be able to help us upgrade that and increase its functionality. So that's pretty cool. One of the new features that I did get from it was increased crawl speed, which is great. He moves significantly faster when crawling now, which is really, really helpful. I like that feature a lot. So you can upgrade it to do different things like that. I know there's one that helps you increase sprinting speed and other such things. Reload speed, I think I have that one. Stuff like that, so it's pretty cool. Although you do need to find some other specific types of engineers to get some of the upgrades. So I just dismounted from D-Horse, ran back for some resources, and then we're going to do a little scouting on the base here. Now, I tried this mission a few times before finally figuring out where I wanted to go in and how I wanted to play things. Now, there's a couple of different ways that you can enter this base. I'm going to show you one in this video. The other one, I'm going to go up and go to the right. The other one, if you go to the left, there's actually a really great infiltration spot that I wish I would have known about before I entered the base, because that's how I ended up leaving, and it was much less troublesome getting out that way, and I imagine it would have been much less troublesome getting in that way as well. So we're just going to mark some guys, kind of get the lay of the land, see where we want to head. So I'm pretty far out from other people and from those guards, so I feel sprinting is a safe option at this distance. Dive. Oh, yeah, there we go. Diving in there. Just dive, dive, dive. Duck, dip, dodge, dive, and dodge, right? Is that what it is? I don't know. Dodgeball was a great movie. All right, so moving on here. So we're going to come out over here. We got a guard shining the light up there. So we'll see if we can come in on his blind side over here. Keep an eye out up this way for any other guards coming our way. Coast looks clear. We got a little guy up there, but I don't think he's going to be a problem for us in the immediate future. All right. Our trank pistol and hold this gentleman up. See if we can get some information out of him. Maybe he can tell us where the prisoner is. We'll see. Spit it out.
Great. I've updated the info on your iDroid. Take a look. I hope he's all right.
So he doesn't have too much info. Or so he says. We're gonna miss and miss. And then just kinda hit him in the stomach. I wanted to make sure that I got this guy out of the way. That way he doesn't wake up later. Because you never know how long a mission is going to take until you're actually in the area of operations. So, you know, I could get in there into this base and see that everything is just totally fucked. And it's going to take me forever to inch my way through because it's, you know, guarded head to foot by the Soviets. But, you know, that doesn't happen to quite be the case in this particular mission, but there are some that does kind of turn out to be what happens. So you want to make sure that you're not leaving anybody behind that's going to wake up and become suspicious. If, you know, they were tranked, or if you knock them out, then they're going to wake up and say, oh, hey, yeah, that stupid one-eyed horn guy knocked me out, and now I got to go catch him. And they're going to alert everybody else, and things are going to get messy. Which happens to me on a number of occasions, which you'll see in the future. But today we're going to end up being pretty sneaky. So manage to avoid those guys coming through that lit up little shack area. Now, something I want to point out is the enemy chatter in this game. I think it's really good. They talk about relevant things. You can gain intel by listening to them, depending on what they're talking about, and other things like that. So it's a really cool feature. It was just nicely done. You know, a lot of games, they have just dumb, inane chatter that doesn't really add anything. You know, there's no atmosphere that's added. There's no information that's added. It's just there to be there. But this one actually has pertinent information to an upcoming mission that I'll show at a later time. But I thought that was pretty cool. And eventually, as you complete missions and build your heroism or your demonism, I think it is. I'm not sure. I've been getting a lot of hero points. But I know that there's an opposite to that as well. So, however you're going about it, you know, you will hear guards talk about you. Like, I was infiltrating a guard post, and I heard one guy talking to the other one, and they said, yeah, have you heard about the man with one eye? They say he has a horn and fights like a demon. And then the other guy says, you know, oh, well, he's probably just a story. You know, people are just getting spooked. And I thought that was a pretty cool touch. And I know they've done things like that in other games, but that's just something that I find cool. Alright, so we managed to avoid those guys. Get up on top of this ridge here. So we have a nice view of the compound. We'll be able to spot all the enemies and decide how we want to proceed. So you can see a lot of these cargo containers that are being identified through my InScope, and those are things that you can Fulton out, and they contain resources. So the different colors indicates the kind of materials that it contains, and you can take those back to Mother Base for a really hefty sum. They contain like 7,500 of whatever resource they have inside of them, so they're really, really handy if you can get them. You know, obviously, if you're in a base like this and you try to Fulton one out without, you know, knocking anybody out or diverting everyone's attention, then they're just going to shoot it down. So you want to be careful about that, and you definitely want to make sure that there's no one around when you're trying to Fulton them, so you can go safely back to Mother Base. Alright, so we're going to notice there's a guy inside this guard station. Now, I can't open the window, and I don't want to break it to get in, because then he'll immediately sense that I'm there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to trank this guy from over here. Make sure nobody's going to see him. So we want to use him as bait for the guy inside of the little bunkhouse. So he's out. And we're going to go back to the back of the bunkhouse and make some noise. So the guy inside is going to come out. So we hit the little blue container. Now, he says, what is that? He's going to come out, and he's going to go around to go through the fence the way that he's supposed to, instead of coming this way. So we're going to go behind the house this way. And as he comes out and sees the other guy, we're going to trank him in the back of his head. One whiff, and we ended up getting them. So now we're going to bring these guys and hide their bodies. We don't want anyone to see them, and I think there's too many guys around for me to safely Fulton them inside of this compound without first disposing of some of the other soldiers. So we're just going to hide them for now. So So here's the control panel. I don't have a way to silently destroy that, so for now I'm going to leave it alone, because the plan is that nobody's going to know that I'm here anyway. Hopefully. Obviously, things don't always go according to plan, as you'll see in some of my later videos, but for now, that ended up being a good choice, because that would have caused an alert, and I didn't actually end up causing one, so that's a plus. Now here, I thought there was a tape in there that I could grab, and this guy was just happened to be in the way, so I was trying to grab that. I ended up moving him, but there was no tape. Sandstorm here can work to our benefit. Just a little bit of cover. Here's the tape that I was looking for. Phantom Pain. So nothing else in this bunkhouse. I think it's time for us to go grab our prisoner. Stash this guy real quick. So we're gonna put him there. And hide against this desk. That way when the guy comes in, he'll come towards us to come wake up his buddy, and we'll take him out. Come on, Jimmy. Let's get the show on the road here. And lights out. Yeah, nothing too special about that guy, so I'm not gonna try and Fulton him. Like this guy just came in to take a snooze. We're gonna leave him alone since he's already taken a nap. Now, starting with the next mission, Mission 6, I ended up not getting that recorded the first time that I played through it, so I'm going to have to play through that again to get that video posted. I'm not sure if I'm going to do that before I get any additional missions posted, so I may end up putting up Mission 7, possibly Mission 10 before I pull up Mission 6, but I do want you guys to be aware that you do have to beat Mission 6 before Missions 7 through 10 are available. But I am going to try and play through that very soon and get that posted, hopefully next, but I suspect that I'm going to get Mission 7 up before then. Alright, so we got took care of that guy. So we got one more guy in here.
Boss, you've entered a building. Always keep an escape route in mind when you head indoors. If you get surrounded, you'll have nowhere to run.
Where are your friends? Spit it out.
Resources. Now, I'm going to unlock the door, but I'm not actually going to grab him yet. I'm going to search the rest of the inside of this building and see what else is around. So there's a whole bunch of resources in here, so I'm glad that we took the time to come look before we completed our objective. Now, as I get farther into the game, these story missions are going to become significantly more difficult, and it's going to take a lot more time. So each of these videos, the permission length is going to increase the farther into the game that we get. I believe it's going to start with mission 6. It's probably going to be about 45 minutes. I think I was just looking at the footage for mission 10 I have, and I believe that's about an hour as well. So they're going to get pretty lengthy, but I am going to put up the whole mission all at once, so it won't just be parts. Alright, so we got our scientist here. Yep, there we go. And we're going to get him out of here. Cut him loose, do a little fireman carry. And peace in the Middle East. See y'all later. Now, I probably could have put him right in that hole right there and Fulton him out that way. And I believe there's a mission task parameter that is doing just that. So I may do that the next time I play through this mission. When I come back for my S rank. I have gotten a couple of S ranks on my first try for some of these missions, but I think it's only like been like 3, and I'm on mission 14 right now, so they can be pretty difficult, and you know, one thing leads to another, and you get a big combat alert, and then, you know, most of the time I'm not equipped for that. I'm equipped for stealth, so you know, I don't really like killing people, but there is going to come a point when my mother base is pretty stocked with, you know, A+, and B soldiers. So I will be doing a lot more killing just to, you know, make sure people aren't coming back. And because I don't want to waste a Fulton on them, because they're not going to, you know, contribute anything to my base anyway. Alright, so that guy thought he saw something, but we averted crisis there. So now we're just going to prove to him that he was right. He did in fact see something, and he should have checked more thoroughly, because it's going to cost him. Hands up. Get down. So I learned there that tranquilizer darts cannot break glass. Yeah, so here's one of those containers that you can fold now, but I do not have the ability yet. Mission 10 is one of the missions that has the specialist you need in order to develop the Fulton for lifting up heavier objects such as cars and containers. So I played through that mission a bunch of different times. I have a lot of different footage of that particular mission. A couple of different ways that I did it, trying to get this guy. So I may put those up if that's something you guys want to see, just one mission with a bunch of different ways that it can be done. I'd be happy to put all that footage up. But as it stands, I'll probably just upload my first playthrough. Because I did okay, and you know, it was just a natural playthrough. So that may be the one that I put up, unless you guys want to see something different. Alright, so we've completed all our tasks, and now we just need to get out of Dodge. Hopefully we can do that, you know, without getting spotted. Calling our air support.
Roger.
close here. Make sure we don't get spotted. It sucks getting spotted on your way out of a mission, just ruining your rating by getting that one combat alert. Take this gun here. There's one. One more gun for us, one less gun for the Soviets. Right the same way that we came in. Just kind of walk up this hill and get on this cliff here. Way to go, mission complete. Yeah, let's see how we did.
This one, boss.
Hey, alright, S rank, not bad. Yeah, so we got no retries, no kills, no reflex, no combat alerts, perfect stealth, no kills. That is how you do it. That is a great infiltration. Like I said, I've only had a few of those, so most of my missions are not going to go that smooth. But, you know, it is what it is. It's a messy game. So, thank you everybody for watching. It's the end of Mission 5, Over the Fence. Mission 6 is where we get our first real cutscene after the intro. So look forward to that. We got that coming up. Now, Miller's going to give us some information about the specialist and what he can do for us, as well as tell us about, I think, a new platform or something that we can develop. So I'm going to be quiet, and you guys can hear all that info if you'd like.
The engineer we rescued has been extremely cooperative. The guys on the R&D team are glad to have him aboard. Thing is, his specialty isn't mechanics, but something called bionics, engineering based on biology. He's already submitted a proposal for modifying your prosthetic arm. If you're interested, go ahead and give the development order.
So we get a new cassette, some emblem stuff. Now we can develop new prosthetic arms, soldier report. So now we're going to head back to Mother Base. I'm going to show you guys a quick cutscene with Dee Dee, who's a diamond dog. He's a great, great buddy to work with. Once I unlocked him, I have used him pretty much nonstop since then. He's awesome. He marks enemies, the same way that you would. They don't get analyzed, but he does show their positions, and they are marked as if you used your in-scope yourself. So that's really, really handy. He can also distract people, and as you level him up and your bond with him increases, you can do things like build stun gear for him, or he can jump up and like deliver electric shocks to people, stuff like that. But I have noticed that you can lose your bond with your buddies as well, so you gotta be careful.
Oh. See that? Now that's discipline. Following orders like a real diamond dog. Soon I'll be... No! Stay! Stay! Go!
Oh, looks like Didi's not quite ready for battle yet. But he will get there. And he's a little badass when he does.
But soon. Soon.
Alright, well, thank you everybody for watching. I appreciate your viewership. If you have any questions or if there's anything that you'd like to see, please leave a comment below. And as always, thank you. And like, comment, subscribe.